and welcome to my channel. I'm Shirley, today I thought I would do a tour of my living room, at least most of it. I've got quite a lot of plants set out here for you, some of my favourites and some new ones. You may have seen some of my plants before, so we'll have like little updates as we go along. Please like and subscribe. Remember, I'm a new channel, I've only been going for a while. So if you do like it, please like and subscribe. I'll be very grateful. So here I have my fireplace, and I thought I'd decorate my fireplace. I have a large hearth, a beautiful window over there. Obviously that's where the TV is, and here are some of my plants. This is George, which I'm sure some of you already know George. He's 35 years old. Isn't he wonderful? And he was quite a bit smaller than this the beginning of this year, actually. He kind of like wasn't growing very much. All of a sudden, whoosh, look at him now. Just look at George. Isn't he doing well? He's doing so well, I don't know where I'm going to put him. Anyway, so I'm really pleased with George. Over here I've just got an iron plant, beautiful iron plant. I've put him on a candlestick. Wonderful things, you know. If you can get some chunky candlesticks, they can really help to lift a plant up on a table, you know, at the back of things. I mean, isn't he elegant? Just look how elegant he is. He's so beautiful. And they say, you know, they don't call them iron plants for nothing. There really isn't a lot that you can do to them to finish them off. They're quite sturdy and beautiful. And here is my little Dracaena. I just can't remember what Dracaena she was. Isn't she beautiful? She's lovely. And she doesn't grow very fast. She hasn't grown very fast this year, but she has put out a few leaves and she's very pretty, isn't she? She's wonderful. So I put her here. And on this table, obviously, I've got a few ornaments. I've got a beautiful light here. My son didn't put it on. I think it's because one of them isn't working. Isn't that wonderful? But I'm going to put it on so you can see one. And then over here, I've got my beautiful new plant. I did have one of these before, Alocasia Amazonica. I always call her Polly because part of her name is Polly something or other. And it's a girl's name, so it's easy to remember. But I had one of these, and we had a fire a while ago. I did a video about it. We had to leave our house, couldn't live here. Everything was covered in ash. It was a terrible, terrible state. And one or two plants did perish as a result of it. But an awful lot of them survived. I brought them all in here, which seemed to be the safest room in the house. I put them all in a line here in the middle so they got some light. You know, this sort of a thing. Anyway, we had to do all kinds of things, decorating and everything, and that side of the house was black, so it was absolutely dreadful. But eventually everything came right. So one or two plants that I had that passed because of it, I don't know if it was the ash on the leaves or what that did it, but anyway. I've replaced, so she's really lovely. Just look at that beautiful, wonderful leaf. I know she's gonna get bigger. I have no idea how much bigger she's gonna get because I honestly can't remember, but she's an absolutely lovely plant, beautiful plant. That's George. You've seen this one before, I think. My Chartreuse, Pothos, called Golden. There's a gold, she's gold, and the other one I think is Golden Pothos. There's two different ones. Anyway, this one is Chartreuse, whereas the other one is a green leaf with yellow running through it. I think that's what it is. And she's beautiful. She was very small when I got her, and she's just starting to grow nicely now. Look at that, isn't that lovely? I don't normally keep her here, but for the video I just wanted to show you how you could decorate. And obviously you don't want to leave some plants in a shady spot for too long, because it doesn't do them any good. But for a week or two, just to give yourself a change, you could do it. These are really old plants now. I'm talking about George, 35 years. Honestly, I don't know how old these are. These could be, I don't know, 20? They've just gone on and on. And every time they die down, you know, I sort of perk them up again, a bit more soil, water, you know, a bit of pruning, this sort of a thing. Did that the other day and they're looking nice now. They don't want to be in here for too long though. They like to be in the kitchen near the window with a diffused, you know, light sort of thing. They seem to be happier there. There's more humidity in the kitchen, so that may be the reason. Here is my wonderful, whoops daisy, beautiful Sansevieria, and this is black coral, and I think I've shown you her before. And when we got her about a year or so ago, she was about like this, and she didn't have that many leaves. She shot right up, and she's borne, if that's the word, more leaves. Just look at them, and there's still some to come. And I think that perhaps I'm getting close to the time when maybe I need to repot her and give her a chance to spread a bit and then grow a bit more, because there's only another, we're in the beginning of July now, aren't we? So 6 weeks of summer growth, and then they're going to start to slow down, aren't they? So I've just been wondering whether to do that, you know. Anyway, so that's my lovely coral. She's just gorgeous. Black coral. And then there's this beautiful one, Flame. I'm sure lots of you have seen her before. They're in the garden centres quite often, aren't they? But they're still absolutely beautiful plants. I mean, just look at her. Isn't she gorgeous? She's gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. So I thought I'd put her in that pot. She looks quite nice there. And then I've got another beauty here, a philodendron. And this one is White Princess. And I think she's magic. I think she's just beautiful. I don't know how big she's going to get, of course, but I mean, she is just lovely. She's got to have some light, I suppose, to bring out the white. And there is even a little pink on the stems, and you can see it from the front as well. So she's got this lovely mixture of this little bit of pink, the lovely green, some speckles, and then some beautiful, almost half moon. I mean, that leaf there is actually pure white. So can you imagine if she's cascading down another year's time or something, or up, if you want to grow her up. You know, you're going to have all these beautiful variegated leaves. I mean, it's just absolutely beautiful. But she's lovely. I think she's lovely. So she's a favourite. So I'm going to put her over there. And then I have my other Pothos. I've put her on a pole. Oops. Oops-a-daisy. And she is my marble queen. Now, I did show you her when she was a lot smaller at the end, earlier part of the year, the beginning perhaps of the year. And just look at that now. Oh. I'm trying to show you, oops, this other side. Because those leaves, they're so beautiful. Can you see them? They don't call a marble queen for nothing. She's lovely, lovely. So I've attached her to a moss pole, but what I've done is I didn't want to staple or use wires that might cut into her. I had some of these clips, the orchid clips, because I have orchids, and I've just literally very gently clipped her here and there. Another one down here, there's another one there, And it's worked quite well. I'm really quite impressed with myself. I thought, ooh, moment of genius there, Shirley. So that was wonderful. So, but she's a bit big to put here with this pole. So we're thinking maybe I might have to cut the pole at the top or just find a different place for her to go. Oh God, she won't stand up now, just as I'm moving on to the next plant. And so what I've done is I've arranged something fairly tall, some gold on the fireplace, and something on the fire there, because we're not lighting them, so it's okay to do these things, isn't it? And on the table over there with some lights between the odd ornament. This one is a sort of garden-like little statue, little fairy. She looks quite nice. So that's the sort of thing I've been doing. And then over here now, I've got my ficus. Let's try and remember what ficus she is. Oh, it's gone. Isn't she lovely? Isn't she just beautiful? Tinekey. T-I-N-E-K-E. I'll put it on the screen. Anyway, she's lovely. She was a lot smaller when I had her. And she's been growing very well. Got a little bit of brown here, which I really ought to try and snip off. But she's got a new branch. Isn't that lovely? And her stem is thickening up nicely at the base. And she's got lovely markings. Just beautiful, beautiful, glossy leaves and lovely markings. So I thought she's just lovely. So I put her next to her sister. Or your sister anyway. Oh, well, Ruby. Can you see Ruby? She has beautiful red in her leaves. Look at this, this is red. And the leaf has a lot of pink and red in it. I suppose it's more pink, isn't it? More pink than anything. But isn't that nice? It's so nice. It's a little change, a little difference from the other one. That comes up green and then they kind of bring in some of this. And she's got a lovely red vein going through there as well, each one of the leaves. Oh, she's beautiful. So I'm just going to put her down here. And this, oops, is a little trick I've been doing. These little white tins, they're really quite nice, sort of fluted. They were actually Easter egg tins, and they had little lids. And what I've been doing is, instead of just throwing them away or whatever, I've used them as stands with my plants. I put them on tables, on shelves. Just today now for you, I'm just doing it here just to give them a bit of a lift. So I just thought I'd show you one of the little things I do. Now this boy is new and he is big. I'm going to try and pick him up. Here we go. Oh, isn't he lush? He's a Alocasia California. And it took me ages to identify him. But he is a California. And one of the ways that you know for sure he's a California, at least mine is, because yes, he's got this lovely big break here in the leaf. And the leaf is an arrowhead shape, but it has this extreme point. You see that point there? And that is how you tell them from the others. And the leaves are kind of rubbery and shiny, and they're a sort of mid-green, and she's now got a new leaf coming up. Just look at that. Absolutely beautiful. And already quite a thick stem. And she's fairly heavy too. So I'm gonna have fun looking after this one. And apparently she's going to grow enormous. I mean, I didn't realize when I bought her, I just thought, oh, you're lovely, I love your big green leaves. You're lovely. But honestly, I didn't realize. And she, between 12 and 18 feet, they say. 12 and 18 feet. honestly, if this happens, I honestly don't know what I'm going to do. I have to learn to, you know, to be able to sort of chop it down a bit. I won't be able to have anything that big, but isn't she lovely? She's just lovely. So I'm really pleased with her. She's just gorgeous. I won't be keeping her in the lounge, I don't think. I think I'm going to take her into the kitchen because there's more humidity in there. But she is just lovely. Another little one we've had just recently. Gorgeous little darling, this one. Some bromeliad. And she is the flaming sword, I think they call her. I'll put the name up so that we get it right. But she's got a kind of tiger stripe going through the leaves. Now, you know, we live in England, and I've seen these like once before, but we don't see them very often. They're quite rare for us. So I don't know about yourselves, but they're quite rare for us. So if anybody's got one, any tips to looking after them, please leave a little comment for me. As with anything else, if you've got one of these plants, for example, it's new to me, so if you know something I don't, you know, like your most important message for me to help look after this one or any of them, actually. I mean, she's just totally beautiful. I don't want anything to happen to her. I've had her for quite a while. She's been reasonably good. I haven't lost leaves or anything like that. She's been good. So that's great. We'll put her back there. Here is my little table. So I've got a little ornament here, a bust, and one of those beautiful little coloured watering things. Just a little something. And then here I have, oh my goodness. Here I have Philodendron Ring of Fire. She's quite rare apparently, and she can get quite big and bushy, and apparently they are climbers. And these leaves will get longer, and they will have like little, I don't know what to call them, like little edges anyway, quite deep little edges. And these leaves will change. Each one will have slightly different coloration. They can have orange in their colouring. They can have pink, a deep pink going through the leaf. You can even get a kind of red. I've forgotten now what else. But they just change colour, and they, you know, one leaf could be orange, another one could have some red, and another one could have something else. And I wish I knew all the colours, but it's like the colours of the rainbow. They're really, really quite beautiful. But it's going to get big again. So like all of our plants, you know, as they get a bit too big, you've got to lop a little bit off, haven't you? And so you can fit them in somewhere in your home and enjoy them, you know. Anyway, she's going to be great. I'm looking forward to her. So look after her. You've seen my beautiful Dracaena here. She's lovely. She's grown up really well now. She looks like a little palm tree. Doesn't she look like a palm tree? She's just beautiful. I just think she's so lovely. She just takes me off to the beach whenever I look at her. So I'll pop her on there. I've put her on a little white raised piece as well, because then, you know, she's higher than the next one's a bit higher, and then they go down like that, so that's nice. On my windowsill, I have another Dracaena, and she's quite beautiful. That's my lemon lime. I love my lemon lime. And she got quite heavy. She grew quite long. She had a lot of leaves, and they're just beautiful, fleshy leaves. Just look at those, velvety. I had to do something. So I took some cuttings, put them in water, got some roots, and then repotted them at the top. And now she's looking a lot better. But I think I need to take maybe another couple of cuttings, and I've got some spaces just here. I could fit another couple in, make her a sort of more bushier, you know. But she's really quite lovely, so I had to show you her. So I brought her over because she's just magic to see. And this is my Anosadia. Never pronounced that word. But this one went through it a bit when the fire was here. She lost a lot of leaves. They went brown. We used to have to keep running over here from the place we were having to stay and water them. And it was the height of summer, it was really hot. And anyway, some of them bit the dust. But the ash is what really did it, because we came back every 3 days and watered them. Anyway, she's recovering now. She's really good. But the other day, I don't know how I did it, I knocked her. And one of her little stems came out, so I've put that in water and I'm, you know, making sure it roots up, and then I'm going to put her back with the main plant and bush her up a little bit. So, but she's quite small at the moment, and they can get quite big, can't they? Big leaves and tall, and you can put them on trellis or posts or what have you. So that'll be nice when she gets a bit bigger. And then here I've got another couple of alocasias who are just babies at the moment. This one is the black velvet. I had to buy another black velvet because she also did not make it. But you know, considering how many plants I had, virtually all of them did. There's just like, you know, four or five didn't, but the rest they managed to keep going. I was spraying them like crazy whenever I came over, leaving bowls of water to, you know, for the water to lift into the atmosphere. So anyway, I finally managed to get another one. She's only a baby at the moment, but isn't she lovely? Absolutely lovely. I'm hoping everything will go well and she'll turn into a proper plant for me. So she's my little baby at the moment. And then I have another little baby who I've never had before. Alocasia Jacqueline. This one is supposed to be rare. And this one is going to get big. If you don't know what these are, they have very large leaves with almost like fingers coming out at the sides. And because the leaves break in the sides. And then this piece here is quite long. And the whole effect is like an arrowhead. And they grow lots of leaves and stems. They get quite bushy in these big leaves. So that's going to be interesting. Very interesting. And the other thing is that they get glossy, but they have lots of coloration lines, like veins going through them that really show up. I'm not sure now whether they're a kind of pink colour, but they really show up and they look so exciting. But I didn't know that when I bought her. When I saw her, I just thought, oh, you look so lovely. You know, that kind of a thing. It hits you. That's it. Too late. You've got to buy it. And so I had her, and later on I looked them up and saw these leaves that I'm going to be enjoying. But I don't know how long it'll take her to grow. I mean, they're only little, and you've got to hope that everything goes well and that you can keep them going and they can grow. So here is the TV in our room. We have it here. And so what I always do is put some plants to each side of me. And over here, I've sort of got the tallest, and I've cascaded them down on some gold, lovely, whoops, little gold plant stands. And you get three, I think, in a pack. If I can find it, I'll put them up in the notes for you, because I think these are just magic. There's a lovely pop of gold in your room, and they're just so stylish, aren't they? They're just so lovely. So I've just arranged them like that. I've had them like this for some time now, and as you can see, tall, lower and lower. And my beautiful, I'm going to bring you back up. Just look at her. Just look at those leaves. And she can get really big, but I haven't repotted her. So if I repot her, she could get quite big. I love this plant. This plant is hardy. She is a calathea, and you wouldn't think that she would manage it to stay in this warm room and be okay, but she is. There's only one leaf that's affected, and that's been like that for ages. None of the others are affected. So this one plant of the calathea group is allowed to stay in here. But I do love her, and she's got some little baby leaves now just coming through, so I'm really happy about that. But I could really do with repotting her now. My Diefenbachia is having problems. I know she needs a drink right now, but she's acting as though she hasn't had a drink forever. So I'm beginning to think that I may have to repot her, have a look at her roots and see what's going on, because she's curling here. So if you have any that do this and you realise what the problem is, leave me a note in the comments, because I don't know everything. But I have had plants for some years, but I don't know everything. And then this one is a Pothos. I want to show you. She's a Hawaiian Pothos. I think she's a Hawaiian Queen. I'm not sure. I did mean to check the name before I started. But can you see this coloration? Look at that. And I know she wants to grow up a bigger pole. I'll have to take her off this little one and do the same as what I've done here for her, because this one is really quite vigorous. She's growing really well and she's so beautiful. Those colours, just look, it's like pineapple yellow in amongst this lovely green. It's just so absolutely beautiful. She's a lovely plant. So she's one of my other Pothos. So I've put her here on a little beautiful little Victorian-like plant stand. I don't think I can get off that easily to show you. But I'd like to show you, because these things are nice to have in your home. I mean, we love our plants and we want to enjoy our plants, but it's also nice to have something stylish to put them on. This is kind of Edwardian-like, isn't it? It's just so lovely. And I'm sure I had another lower one that went with it, that went in through there for storage, and then you come out sort of like this and put your two plants on. But I just don't know where it is. I can't find it. It's annoying. But anyway, so I've just put that there for now. So I've got all the golds coming through together. And my lovely plant at the back there is doing really well. She's growing great. And I've bought myself Estramalthi. Aren't they beautiful? I mean, they've been around for so long, in all the shops, forever. But you just can't resist that, can you? Just look at those colours. Aren't they beautiful? That beautiful pinky, purpley red. Oh, wonderful, absolutely wonderful. So, I've got her as well. And I've just been enjoying placing the plants in lovely areas and places that you can have. Most of them you can keep in these places, but some of them, of course, you might have to move if you were doing it yourself because of the... This is the east window. It doesn't get a lot of brilliant, harsh sun. That's the south and that's the west. So those are the two windows I have to be really careful of. But they have so much light that comes in, it does flood through the room. So quite a few plants I can keep there for, you know, a week or two, and then change them out and put something else there. So that I can just enjoy the different plants, putting them around. So I hope you've enjoyed that. And some of my new ones, my alocasias and my babies, and my Pothos and my room. And I hope you've enjoyed this and will come and join me again when I do another plant tour. I'm thinking of doing one possibly in my dining room next time. I've got loads of other plants in there as well, and I try to style them so that they don't look like all on one shelf and, you know, too much kind of thing. It's really difficult when you've got a lot of plants. You know, you go out to the garden centres and that, and you see something new and you think, oh my goodness, I've got to take it home, and then what? When you come back, it's like, where do you go? Anyway, alright, and so I hope you've enjoyed this, and hope to see you again soon. Please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed some of the things that I've shown you, and I'll see you again later.